Good morning, boys and girls. My name is Teacher Khomotso. I hope you're all excited today. It's a lovely Sunday, blessed, and we are highly favored. And without wasting any time, can you please just close your eyes and open up in prayer? Heavenly Father, we just want to thank you for today. We want to thank you for everything that you have done for us and everything that you are going to do. Mighty God, I pray that with the person that is going to share today, I hope that it will dwell in our hearts and that we will place action into it. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. Alrighty, boys and girls, it's time for praise and worship. So I hope you're excited. Please stand up and let's get ready to dance and sing for the Lord.
Touching every heart, I worship you. the splendor of a king, clothed in majesty, let all the earth rejoice, all the earth rejoice. He wraps himself in light, and darkness tries to hide, and trembles at his voice, and trembles at his voice.
How great!
Yeah.
Hello, my name is Samgan. I greet you in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. I miss my friends at school and I miss my friends at church. I love you. Bye. Amen.
Alrighty, boys and girls. So now we're about to hear from the teacher. I hope they're going to bless us. I hope the message is going to just fulfill our hearts and spirits. And without wasting any time, let's sit down, let's keep quiet, and let us get ready to hear what the Lord has to say.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much for the beautiful songs that we've been singing along and to the lovely messages that you are busy sharing, that you continue to share with your friends. Continue to reach out, continue to show them support, continue to love them at this time that we are unable to meet together. But your love and your messages that you're sending to your friends means a lot, and it goes the long way to your friends. Remember, we are the church that seeks to demonstrate God's unconditional love and to develop Christian leaders that will equip the marketplace for Christ. We also know that God is at the head and the love is at the center of all that we do as Agape Family Church. We thank you for joining us again this morning, boys and girls, as we continue to worship together and fellowship together at this time. Let us bow together and give glory to God. Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you for your grace. We thank you for your love. We thank you for your support. We thank you for your mercies that are renewable each and every morning. When we say this is the day that you have made, Lord, we will continue to rejoice and be glad in it. We give you all the glory, Ramasedi. As we decrease and you increase, Lord, we continue to sit here to hear you speak. Spirit of the living, hear our prayers this morning. Mighty God, we praise your name and we continue to sit at your feet to hear your word, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Amen. Thank you so much, Kidz. As we gather here today, we are going to break the bread together. And in breaking the bread together, we're going to read from the book of Psalms 27, verse 13 and 14. I will allow you to take time to get to gather your Bibles as we open together book of Psalms 27, verse 13 and 14, and I'm going to read from the book of NIV. When you're ready, we're going to read together. Let's read. I remain confident of this. I will see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait for the Lord, be strong and take heart, and wait for the Lord. This is the beautiful message that we're getting from the Psalms 27. This is David speaking to the Lord as he prays him and praying to him. It is very important that we also continue to have the conversation with God at all times, more so when we are seeking guidance and wisdom, when we are faced with decisions that we need to make. As young as you are, I know that most of the time you find yourself having to make decisions, having to make sure that you have solutions for things that are bothering you. But today we are gathered here to be rest assured that when we run to God and we seek his face and we seek his guidance, he will give us the wisdom that we need. Just like David, when he looked up to God and says, I remain confident of this. I will see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. You can also be assured and send that same message and pray the same prayer to God and says, Lord, I remain confident of this, that I will see your goodness in the land of the living. So today, wherever you are, it doesn't matter where you are, wherever you are, stop and seek God's face and call upon him, and he will hear your prayers and he will answer your prayers in this lifetime. That is the promise that he made for us as his children. We remain hopeful that we have God, that as we keep on asking him, as we keep on going to him at all the time, through this uncertainty that we are facing as his children, we know that we are also not sure when are we going to go back to school, but we are being assured that we will go back to school. And for those of us who are able to continue to study and continue school online, We are then given that opportunity to continue, but we know that at this uncertainty that we are facing, God is always at the midst of all that. And we remain hopeful that we will go back to school, because he has promised us that whatever that we seek, his goodness, it will show to us at this time of the land of the living and in this lifetime. Verse 14 says, wait for the Lord. As we continue to wait for the Lord, we're being encouraged that let us wait for the Lord. Let us hear him speak to us. We know that sometimes waiting is a difficult thing that we do as children of God. We become impatient, but we are reminded on this verse that let us wait on the Lord. Wait for the Lord. Be strong and take heart and wait for the Lord. It is important to wait. And while we're waiting, we listen. And when we listen, he speaks to us, and we can see him when he speaks through all the guidance that he gives us and all the things that we see happening around us. We are being assured that God listens and God answers the prayers. And at this difficult time that we face ourselves too, as the children of God, he will answer our prayers. And every day he continues to answer our prayers. What we need to do, we need to remain in him, and we need to remain using his strengths, because we know that our strength fails us along the way, but his strengths remain in us, and we continue to give our time to him. We continue to sit and seek him, and we fully surrender ourselves to him, and we remain in him and allow him to use us. And in that way, we will hear him speak to us, and he will answer our prayers, and we remain to continue to seek guidance from him, continue to ask for wisdom from the Lord, as we know that his goodness, it's always there with us. We know that his love, it's what protects us. We are centered in his love, we are centered in his guidance, and we seek him all the time. So let us continue to be reassured that God is at the midst of everything else, and he will give us courage to face whatever challenges that we are facing, especially now at this time, that we continue to sit by his feet and listen to him and hear him when he speaks to us. This is the message that I wanted us to share today with you, Kidz Zone, that let us seek his face, let us continue to wait for him. Let us be courageous and be strong and know that his goodness will pass at this time that we seek him. Let us pray together. Father God, we thank you for the reassurance that we remain in you, that it's only you, by your strength, that we will rise, knowing that you are our light, O Lord. You are our peacemaker. You are our way maker. You are our faith, Lord. You are faithful, O Lord, and we trust you that in your faithfulness that you will complete your work in us. And on the land of the living, we continue to give you glory. We continue to seek your face, Lord Almighty, as we wait to hear you. Continue to give courage, Lord, to give us courage to stand still and know that you are God, and know that through you, Lord, we will achieve all that needs to be achieved. In the mighty name of Jesus, Heavenly Father, we continue to seek your face and to praise you and to seek guidance. Lord, we thank you as we continue to go through this week. We commission this week into your hands. We say, Lord, guide us and give us strength. In the mighty name of Jesus, Lord, we pray and we praise your name. Amen.
Boys and girls, now it's time to close, and I just wanted to say thank you so much for joining us. Thank you so much for just being here and just having to hear what God wants us to learn, what God wants us to hear. And right now I'm going to ask us to close our eyes and let us pray. Heavenly Father, we just want to say Thank you for today. Thank you for the birds that sing. I thank you, oh God, for the knowledge that you have placed in our teachers. I thank you for the wisdom you have placed in our teachers in order for them to teach us. In Jesus' mighty name I pray, we glorify you, we worship you. In Jesus' mighty name I pray, amen. Alrighty, boys and girls, we'll see you next time, same place. Bye.